Good evening. I'm Pastor Brent Byerman. I welcome you tonight. You remember last year on the 4th of July, we couldn't do anything? Aren't you glad to be in God's house tonight celebrating our freedom, our birthday? We're glad. You know, you notice the women wore red, white, and blue. You don't see too many men. They're wearing like dark gray and you women do a lot better in the colors. Some of your men had some red, white, and blue. We're glad you're here tonight. We're glad to celebrate the birthday of our country and the freedoms, that God's freedoms and our national freedoms that being a part of our country is the right and our gifts. I want to begin with a word of prayer, and then I'll turn it over to Danny Comfort and our musicians. Let's go to God in prayer. Father, every good gift comes from you above. And we have no doubt that you, as Lord and Savior, have been at work in our country through our history. And tonight, we give you thanks. We give you praise for those who have served, for those who have fought, for those who have defended the freedoms that we benefit today. We thank you for those warriors and servants. But most of all, Lord, we give you thanks to you tonight for the gifts that you've given us in this country and also through your gift of Jesus Christ. And it's in his name we give you thanks. And all God's people said,
amen. Would you please rise and sing the national anthem with us? Be seated. We have a lot of movement tonight back and forth. We're blessed to have people that are in all three ensembles, so it's a little hard to get from place to place one time. Okay, am I on now? Judy number one. Mike number one. Okay. Thank you for coming tonight, and hope you know. I was saying we have people that are in all three ensembles, and so we'll be doing a lot of moving around tonight. But I'd like to turn the program over to William Murphy and the Lake Magdalene Ringers. Thank you. I've included a number of sing-alongs tonight. You're going to be busy. And this first one that we're going to do is, and by the way, it was great to hear the national anthem sung like that. It's been so long since we've heard a group sing. It's lovely. This is a tribute to those in the armed forces, all five branches, and we ask the words will be projected on the screens for you. Please sing along, and would you stand if you are a veteran of one of those services when your song is played?
Let's go.
It's your turn again. This is an American celebration. It is a collection of five folk songs of Americana, and please sing with us.
Thank you.
Isn't it great, with all the political stuff going on all the time, together as God's people, and to simply thank Him for the blessings, His blessings to our country. Amen? Isn't it good to be in the do that? In our tradition on Sunday morning here in this house, we greet one another with the peace, with the pastor saying, the peace of the Lord be with you, and you saying,
and also with you.
Would you stand and simply greet those around you for a moment and wish them God's peace and give thanks for them being here tonight? And you may be seated. We're going to take an offering. That's what you do in church, don't you? The offering is not going to our church ministries, but to the music ministries of the church, so we can do more concerts and stuff like this. So if you'd like to give tonight, that's fine. We're actually going to pass the plates tonight. Do you believe that? During COVID, we've had usually boxes at the door, so we need to see if we can remember how to do this. So as the ushers come forward, let us offer our gifts to the Lord's ministry.
The Testament of Freedom is based on the writings of Thomas Jefferson. The first movement was written 2 years before the U.S. Declaration of Independence. In this document, Jefferson laid out for our delegates to the First Continental Congress a set of grievances against King George III and his response to the Boston Tea Party. In the document, Jefferson declares that the British Parliament did not have the right to govern the 13 colonies. The second and third movements were written 1 year before the Declaration of Independence. This document, written by Jefferson and issued by the Second Continental Congress, explained why the 13 colonies had taken up arms in what had become the American Revolutionary War. The fourth movement, written in 1821, is an excerpt from the letter from Jefferson to John Adams, commenting on world events and the United States' role in restoring light and liberty to Europe. In 1776, John Adams persuaded the Congressional Committee to select Jefferson to compose the original draft of the document we know as the Declaration of Independence. The Declaration was ultimately a formal explanation of why Congress had voted on July the 2nd, 1776, to declare independence from Great Britain more than 1 year after the outbreak of the American Revolutionary War and 241 years ago. Randall Thompson, a prominent American composer, selected these texts in 1943. The piece was written to celebrate the bicentennial of the birth of Thomas Jefferson. Consequently, the text and the work were taken from his writings. On April the 14th, 1945, it was performed by the Boston Symphony Orchestra at Carnegie Hall as a part of a concert in memory to Franklin Delano Roosevelt, who had died 2 days earlier. So the continuity of the work will not be interrupted. We ask that you hold your applause until the conclusion of the entire work. I would encourage you to follow along in your program to these words. They are words we need to be reminded of. We've kind of forgotten some of the things that made us a country. And this is a text that will bring those things back to your mind. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being a part of the evening, and we wish you a happy fourth next week. Hope we've kind of set the tone for the week. And our pastor has something to say. Of course he's got something.
Would you thank Mr. Comfort for his gift? Stay standing, if you would. I want to do two things before you leave. God has led our country in the past. I want to pray tonight that he'll lead us into the future. Amen?
Amen.
And we prayed this morning, but I want to pray for those that are surrounding that building in Miami and waiting to hear all those families. Father, first of all, I want to pray for those people. That you will be with them in every way, that you'll continue to raise up support people, praying people that will be with those families, those rescue workers. This is their part of us and we're part of them, and I pray that you be there in a mighty way in Miami, surrounding that building and what's happening there with those people. And Lord, we have celebrated tonight you leading us into freedom from our past and our history. And with all that's going on in our country now, we pray, Lord, we pray tonight that you will lead us into your future for our country. And we pray this in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Would you go forth tonight? May God lead you in his peace. And again, may the blessings of God the Father, may the blessings of God the Son, and may the blessings of God the Holy Spirit be with you. Thank you. And may he remain with you always. And again, God's people said,
Amen.
God bless you. Thank you.